So let's just look at the green car. Just the green car. All right. See if you can tell me how much it will cost to drive the green car, all totaled up, for 50 miles. 50 miles. How much will it cost to drive the green car? All the fees included. Okay. Look at that for a second.
Dollars.
$775. How's that sound? Reasonable?
Yes.
No. You
no, sorry.
Don't
sorry. I meant to say no.
No, you don't think that sounds right, $775?
No.
You want to get something different from $775?
That's
$75. $75. Anybody else get $75? Anybody else get anything different? $7.50. Because it's just saying numbers.
I was saying both of numbers.
You get one answer. It can't possibly be two different costs to drive the same number of miles. Yes?
Yeah,
$14.
$14. So, how'd you get
14? Let me ask you this. How much would it cost to drive this car 0 miles?
It's nothing.
You use $0.
Yes.
Oh, $15.
$15. It costs $15 to drive this thing 0 miles.
To fill it up.
What? No.
To buy
the car.
To
rent it.
$15. Oh,
it's $15.
$15.
Plus 50 cents per mile.
Yes.
Right? If I drive it no miles, it's still $15 plus. $0 because it didn't drive it 80 miles, right? So let's try again. How much would it cost you to drive 50 miles? Great.
5 times 50?
50 miles. So 15 plus 0.5 times 50 would be like in 1 minute taking a homework review, so I think it should stop wasting time. So 15 plus, what's 0.5 times 50? If I paid 50 cents for every mile and I drove 50 miles,
225.
So 25 plus 15?
Is
40.
40.
Okay. This is how much it costs to drive it for 50 miles. How much would it cost to drive it for X miles?
40.
I don't know. What do you want
to do? 40 times X.
15 plus 0.5x.
I hear 15 plus 0.5x. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
If, well, if I drove it for 40 miles, would it change it to 40? If I were to drive it for 100 miles, would I just put 100 here instead?
Yeah.
If I were to drive it for X miles, would I put X here instead?
Yes.
And we go, what we get there?
X.
Right? 0.5 times the number of miles plus 15 cents. Or sorry, $15. How about for this one? How much would it cost to drive the second car for X miles?
Oh, I had a question. How did you get 0.5
times 50? How much would it cost to drive the second car for X miles? Right?
25 plus 2.5.
2.25 times X miles. Okay, so if I plug in the number of miles, will this tell me how much the blue car costs?
Yeah.
If I plug in the number of miles into X, will it tell me how much the green car costs over here?
Yeah.
Okay. And the problem says I want the amount of money to be the same. I want to figure out when do these two cars cost exactly the same. For not very many miles, this costs less, right? For 0 miles, it costs $15. For 0 miles, this one costs $25. So I'm going to go with this one if I need to drive a car 0 miles. I'd also want to go with this one if I only wanted to drive like 5, probably. But at some point, right, this costs more per mile than this does. It costs twice as much. And it's going to catch up. Like, this is going to get more expensive eventually, right? Kelly, just sit right here.
What?
Whether you're talking or he's talking to you.
No one's talking.
Who's Cole?
Cole and Colby, then Cole.
Kelly.
So we want the amount of this car to come out the same as the amount of this car. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. Good idea of just plugging in numbers for X?
Sure.
That's what you're saying in the hall. So you could just plug miles in for X, stand in the hall, not walk down the hall. No, you're not. Stand outside the door. Stand right next to the door. So, I could plug numbers in for X, but that's not really algebra. That's just guessing and checking. But this will tell me how much it costs for the green car. This will tell me how much it costs for the blue car. And I want the costs to be
the same,
equal to each other. Let's solve this equation. Let's cancel out the X's on one side. How are we going to do that, Brandon?
So you go 15 divided by 5.5x.
Just hold up on dividing till the very end. Sit.
Track.
You should subtract 0.5 on the side.
Try 0.5x.
Yeah.
15. 0.5x minus 0.5x.
Zero.
Outside the door.
0x.
0x, okay, equals 25. What's 0.25 minus 0.5x? 0.25x minus 0.5x.
20.
'Cause we like to have x's on one side and numbers on the other side. Right? We don't like to have them all on one side and zero on the other, but that's what happens if we subtracted 15 from both sides. What's 15 minus 25?
20. Negative 10.
Negative 0.25x. Now we're going to get x by itself. Kelly.
We add 0.25.
That would be true if I had x minus 0.25. But it's negative 0.25 times x, so how would I cancel out the negative 0.25?
Divide.
Yeah.
Be quiet.
Got it. Okay. So, you know it's going to be positive? Negative divided by negative is positive. What's 10 divided by 0.25?
Negative positive
40. 40. So after 40 miles, these two will cost the same.
If you do minus 15, we're just put the same answer.
Well, what's going to happen if I subtract 15 from both sides is I will get 15 minus 15 is 0, equals 25 minus 15 is 10, minus 0.25x. So, got a couple more steps to go before I get it, but just look at the right answer. I just just more steps.
Okay.
More to do.
So basic.
Oh.
Go ahead, Sid.
Oh, I was just gonna ask him.
Well, 3 minutes.